Hello, you revolver tossalots. Jim Sterling here, and this is Cross of the Dutchman. This is a game that I wouldn't ordinarily do this style of game, not because I don't like this style of game. I like this style of game quite a lot, but I don't tend to find their very good videos. They make or at least I don't make them entertaining videos. However, Cross of the Dutchman has mine eye. I'm very interested in seeing how this one works, and it seems like I may be able to draw some entertainment from it. So let's go. When it comes to these sort of action-adventure, top-downy, looking-y ones, It's not an indictment of the game that I can't make it interesting, it's an indictment of me. But anyway, this is in the 16th century. It's based on a real-life legend, don't you know? I know that much about it. I can't remember anything about the legend, but we do know that several factions are trying to get hold on the land so they can consolidate their old power there. There's a fellow with a beard. A lot of beardy people back in them days. You got ordinary Frisian people at the Donia family. Now, they just want to be left in peace, okay? Don't bother them. Don't worry about it. As you can see, though, another beard, lots of beards. That was the style of the day, of the era. Beards and shirts with those little cross-stitchy things at the front. That's how you know it's ye olden times. Rather than the modern age. But anyway, here's Pier. He's glad he's finished with that. He worked up quite an appetite, so that's all right. I really hope Rintz has prepared something good today. Right, here we go. Using a control of this, it just felt like the kind of game. Oh, look at that. Advanced shovel climbing physic technology. Not many games have shovel climbing. So this is Rintz. Hello dearest, have you finished preparing that field for growing season? I've been breaking my back over it all morning, it's all been taken care of, cool. She's been busy, but she hasn't gotten around to preparing a meal. Oh no, that's exactly what Pierre wanted! Luckily, Pierre wants to help out. So, they're all out of meat and fish, so we're gonna have to head to the market and trade some of the vegetables. Ah, God. He wants to send the kids, but she hasn't seen them. Bit irresponsible. Besides the fact I could see one in the corner of the screen just then. Lazy. But gather some vegetables, take to the market. Help. You can use the mini-map. Helps to have a map. I almost said helps to have a map before I mentioned the mini-map. That's where my priorities are. Pierre doesn't know what a mini-map is. That's self-referential. Breaking the fourth wall there. Very cheeky. So she doesn't want this to be complicated, okay? Video game jokes. Cool. Right, well, there's a bit of cauliflower, anyway. There's another one. And we got the mini-map there. Helps to have a mini-map. I mean, I've already said the helps to have a map thing, but doing it again. Doing it again out of sheer desperation. Right, so presumably the little reticule in the map there is where our fourth and final vegetable. There's a kid right there. Girl off, you go get fucking vegetable. Oh my God, what's wrong with that kid? Oh, that's some Jacob's Ladder shit. All right, I don't want to talk to you anymore. No, go away. They're playing hide and seek. Right, yeah. You go off and do whatever it is you want to do, you creepy little Cenobite fuck. See if she's any better. Nope, she's also some twitchy Silent Hill monstrosity. That's Wobble here. Wobble very much, named after her own head. Can we play at the other side of the farm? Only if Wilk can keep an eye on you both. Because apparently your mother can't. Alright, Dad. Irresponsible parents. The pair of them. Right. So anyway. We got our vegetables. Here you go. A whole bunch of vegetables gathered from around the farm. It looks like you've got to bring the carrots. Go across the ditch. Oh my God. Okay, off we go to get carrots. This is an action-adventure game. I want to get to the action and the adventure. I mean, I'm all for a slow build. I'm all for pacing. But you made me run around getting carrots. Getting cauliflowers, rather, and radishes and whatever. We've already nailed the principal idea of picking up vegetables. but that's fine. We're going to go get them. We shall dutifully recover our carrots. At least we're not having to go hunting around for them. Thanks to the mini-map. Which
it helps to have.
Okay. They look more like radishes or turnips than carrots. And he doesn't really sort of feel like an errand boy. Making fun of video game quests by giving us a video game quest. Uh-oh. Fucking brigands. What are you doing on my property? Shut up and hand over the money. I ain't got money, I got carrots. You inept brigand fucks. He'll make short work of both of them. We'll take that challenge any day. Okay, it's a fight. Okay, I guess... No, that's not the... Oh. Hey, right, gotcha. I see it in the corner. My mind... I'm on the DualShock 4. My fingers automatically went to square. Because that's normally where you do your attacks. But it's that your X button here. These fools thought they could come to my place and... You step to me! The nerve, he says. Go on, fucking drown him in the river. 'Tis no more than brigands deserve, forsooth. So, heading back with our carrots and our fists bloody. After beating up dangerous men. But we got the carrots, that's the main thing. You won't believe what just happened. I got ambushed by a bunch of crooks on our own land. Just if they're hurt, he's... Well, we did take a wallop. But... Anyway, he's showing off. He's playing all the bravado machismo. Toxic masculinity, that's what that is. In need of serious medical attention. And he probably, right, broke his fists on their face. Bleeding internally from the battering they gave him. But because he's got to play the yard man, he's going to act like the big I am. Oh, I'm not hurt at all. I can see blood all over his bandaged hands. How did they get bandaged in the first place? Probably burned them in a fire and was just like, no, I'm all right. And then they said, get your hand out the fire, Pierre. And he's like, no, doesn't hurt at all. While he's in agony. Because he's got to show off. That's just one aspect of toxic masculinity, which, contrary to people's confusion, is not a criticism of masculinity itself. You know, it's a subset of it. Which is the bad bit of it. Because there's a bad bit of a lot of things. But that's me just inserting politics into the video. Ambushing you with it. Because why not? If you think that's bad, you're not going to like this week's Gymquisition. I say next week's rather. Anyway, she's telling us about the things that are dangerous. The Saxon soldiers, they've reached the villages of Kimsword and Arum. And she doesn't know what's next. He'll make sure to keep a watchful eye from now on. Take our savings to the crossroads, just in case you need to pay to stay out of trouble. Wait. So take all of the money out onto the road where the brigands are. This is a family of incompetent boobs. Take the savings from the chest. Unbelievable. Leave him in the... Why is the chest outside? Why are there just flimsy crates full of gold? This is the family's life savings and it's out in a chicken coop. Well, anyway, he doesn't want to hand over the savings to the Saxon bastards. I mean, if he goes out on the road and those very same Saxon bastards shoot him to death with flat bows, then all of their money goes with him. Leave it in the locked chest. And put the locked chest in a house or bury it or... The logic of this family. He's off to the crossroads. Please don't get yourself in any kind of trouble. If you ever get lost, you can use the world map. Helps have a map to find your way back home. Sounds good. How do we use the world map? That's not it. There we go, pressing the touchpad on the old DualShock 4 there. Gives us a lovely map. Right. Can we move faster than this? No. Whose chest of money is that? Is that theirs? Have they left this out? Like, just... I am very, very concerned about the financial decisions this family is making. Very concerned. I have my... I'll just say it again, concerns. I was trying to think of another better word for it, but no. Oh my god, who's this? Are you a Saxon bastard? Are you alright? I'm gonna swing at you just in case. He just runs off. What are you yelling for? It says quick attack when we're near him. Or that might be... It's probably just talking about these crates. Which I'm assuming belong to this fella here. And he's just fine with it. He's just letting us do it. That's alright. So anyway, here's the fishmonger. Hello, good man. I would like to trade my vegetables for some of your finest fish. So, they're telling us their fish is the freshest we can get, but they want coins only. Okay, he's angry about that. But he says, your vegetables look fine, it's just that I have to pay a lot more taxes now that those fucking Saxons, they've come to the village and now they need coin. These guys are everywhere and now they're even getting between me and the meal. Look here, big guy, those soldiers have taken a good portion of my catch today because I was not able to pay them. I'll trade with you if you can get the fish back. Okay. He'll return the fish. They're well armed. Could you not have... Like, there's a shovel in Pierre's yard. If he was expecting trouble, he could have just brought the shovel at least. Luckily, there's a weapons dude over here. Anything you're willing to trade? I'm sorry, coins only. Alright, well, I've got coins. I've got coins. There's no other button, it's just talking, and he's just... Pierre, you fucking moron! You've got money! Alright, fine. Fine. Hold it right there, peasant. Let me pass. I have no business with you. Oh, but I'm afraid you do. See, everybody has to pay a toll in order to get to Adam, no matter how big and stupid they are. Uh-oh, Pierre's not happy with that. Okay, well, we ain't gonna pay no toll, are we? Someone ought to teach you a lesson. Picking a fight you can't win. Bashy, 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 bashy. Bashy, bashy, bashy. Bashy, bashy, bashy. This combat system ain't $2,000. I want to get some distance, see if there's blocking or dodging or... Nope, it's just bashy-bashy. Alright. Looks like I knocked these guys out cold. Better start looking for those fish. Maybe pick up the sword. No? Don't fancy it? Alright. God, this is running quite bad. Look at that. You've got so much money, Pierre. And you won't even stump up for a fucking sword. Uh-oh. That's a lot of brigands. I guess they're soldiers, not brigands. You thought you did surrender and get the hell out of our camp. Have we got another fight on our hands? No. I need to come up with something different to get the hands on the fish. You could just beat them up. Ask the fishmonger for help. Or just buy a big fuck-off axe. There is a polearm there. That's a fucking halberd. I reckon you could get that. These guys are desperate for money anyway. You could have them over a barrel. For about 5 coins, we could get that halberd, some fish, and one of these fucking bits of meat here. But no, we've got to do things a complicated way. Pierre's a moron. He's able to fight off a couple of soldiers, but backup arrived. They threw him out. This is quite troublesome. Should easily be able to take on a large group. Perhaps you should go and find Swat to Garrett. He is the blacksmith from Aram. I'm sure he has something that will help you out. He's never heard of him, but you don't think the soldier bought the entire road. That's what I figured, no worries. Get often travels to Kimsworth to help shoe horses on the farms. I've seen him come by just this morning. You should be able to catch up with him quickly. Okay, so we're going to find Get just east to Kimsworth. Once you're there, you will have to ask around. I'm sure people will have seen him come by. Okay. Off to find the blacksmith man. So yeah, I mean, it looks... It's got a nice little art style and stuff to it, but it doesn't run very well, and the combat is very stodgy. I don't know if that expands as we go on. Hopefully it does. But right now, let's say I'm not immediately impressed. I'm not turned off entirely by it. I'm not, you know, I'm having a laugh at how stupid Pierre is, but I'm not genuinely pissed off at it or anything. But anyway, the road to Kim's where now to find that black... That's exactly what we were doing, Pierre! I said I'm not really that pissed off, and then he goes and does something fucking stupid. Like explaining why we're here when that's what we're here for. That's why I came here. Okay. Look at that. There's a... Pierre, pick up the axe. Pierre, pick up the axe, you fuck. 124 gold now. He could have bought all the fish. All of it. Who are you? Are you him? Oh, this is Sibrant. Who might you be? You don't look like a farmer. This is Sibrant. He became a hunter after deserting the military. Could not stand the horrendous things he had to do. Are you sure you severed ties with those bastards? I swear I'll find you if you rat me out to those villains. Holy shit, Pierre. Not only is Pierre a dum-dum, he's an asshole as well. Anyway, he's more known to them. Just call on me if you ever need someone to aid against the Saxons. I really don't want to get into more trouble than I already am. Just know you can call on me if you need my help. Well, that would be good. But no, Pierre's just not bothered. Not bothered by that. Alright, there we go, look. That's a blacksmith if ever I saw one. Okay. You must be Gert. Help me. I'm thrown out of a soldier's camp and I need to teach those morons a lesson. Pierre calling someone a moron. That's a pot and a kettle if ever I saw it. I figured you're the kind of guy who can get himself into trouble easily. You're calling me a troublemaker? Among other things I'd call him. Easy, fellow. I'm just saying that you really stand out of the crowd. The soldiers love to pick on you. I guess you're not far from the truth, but I have matters to settle. Are you going to help me or not? What a rude bastard. Okay. He can only give us some advice rather than sell us a sword. Hey, I know where there are swords that you can buy, Pierre. Well, aren't you the disappointing black... Holy shit. He owes you nothing, Pierre, you ungrateful prick. His advice is worth 100 pieces of gold. Jesus Christ. Pierre, don't give him the gold. Just buy the sword at the place. In the... Ugh. But you want to trade vegetables for swords, Pierre? Alright, fine. Would you... Okay. He just forked it right over. He just forked them... This blacksmith said a sword would be better. He said if he were at his shop, he'd have just sold him a sword. Now, we know where that... Okay. I'm not going to hang up on it. I'm going to move on. I won't get myself caught. Let's just continue. What you need to do is learn to control that anger of yours, build it up, let out a furious blow. Take a breather during a fight. Sounds pretty dumb. Well, that's right up your alley, Pierre. Why don't you give it a try? Keep calm until your stamina bar, then release a mighty blow. Stamina bar? You sound just as crazy as my wife! Yeah. Really self-referential. Always fun. Just give it a shot. You can try punching those barrels over there. Using regular punches won't work. Okay. Oh, it's just B. Okay. Look how much gold we're down. That's pathetic. That's pretty impressive. I can tell there is a lot of strength hidden inside those fists of yours. Can you imagine, right? If in Conan the Barbarian or something, right? Just for the sake of argument. Conan meets a blacksmith and is like, blacksmith, I need to get rid of this evil wizard. Right? And the blacksmith's like, all right, give us 100 bits of gold, right? And I'll see you through. I'll see you right. And Conan's like, ha, 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 here is some gold. And then the blacksmith's like, ha, 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 try punching him harder. And then Conan's like, yeah, all right. That's worth 100 gold coins for you to tell me to hit something harder. I mean, somebody tells me Conan would not have been as great a story as it was, as revered as it was in fantasy circles, if that's how the story went down. Anyway, thanks for the advice. He's happy. I mean, I would say he has just been robbed blind, never mind the brigands or the Saxons. But Okay. Return to the fishmonger. Unbelievable. Gert the Blacksmith is the biggest fucking villain of the series so far. I say series. As if this is going to become an annualised franchise like Assassin's Creed. I know there are other treasure chests over there, but I can't be fucked. Right, back to the fishmonger. Right now, my mind is just reeling from the rampant stupidity I'm seeing from the from our protagonist. You've come back, have you found Swate Gerte? You bet I have. You'd better get ready to trade those fish with me. I'm putting an end to this right now, because I've been told how to punch things hard. Okay. You sure you don't want to go? Why would I even try again? Right, come on. You again. Those soldiers you knocked out are in a bad way. We won't go easy on you this time, you filthy peasant. Come and get it. Right, I can punch hard. Okay, where's the meter for this? It's the green one, okay. God, there doesn't seem to be any targeting or anything. It's just... that's horrible. Combat system isn't good. I've decided. Incredible, I've never felt so strong in all my life. I guess that old blacksmith's advice was worth more than I... worth more?! I actually wouldn't put it past Pierre to go back to the blacksmith and give him the rest of his money. Hey, you telling me to punch things hard turned out to be even more valuable. Have all of my life savings and all of these vegetables. We'll go hungry tonight. It's fine. I don't need no fish. Unbelievable. There's no money left. You know what? Don't even return the fish. You've got the fish. Just take it fucking home. Total nonsense. Right. I took care of those creeps by doing hard punching. They start wearing some armor and think they can push people around. Okay, keep the fish as a token. See, I'm going to keep it anyway. Then those soldiers will be back. Okay. Let them come, he says. Right, we're heading back home. We've got our fish. What's the bet when we get home and tragedy has struck? That's how these things normally go down. I wouldn't put hard money on it, but... it's the perfect setup for it. Get off the bush. Right. Back to the farm. I see another red chest over there. Let's do that. We really need money now that we've spent it all being told to punch things hard. Push these boxes up as well. Bit more money for me, thanking you kindly. Okay, well, we've almost made our money back after spending it on the worst advice in the world. Not that I'm bitter about it in any way, shape, or form. I'm just fine with it. Hello, love. Was I able to get some fresh fish? I read that all wrong. Are you sure these fish haven't gone bad? Got criticizing. So anyway, he's telling her that he beat up soldiers. She says he went out of your mind. Yes, he is. He's clearly dangerously stupid. Again with that. She's like, well, the soldiers are going to come and fuck shit up. And he's like, eh, don't worry about it. I'm here. So I'm... it's brilliant. Anyway, Pierre rinsed their children, enjoying a hard-earned meal of vegetables and fish. God, I'm just waiting for the tragedy to strike. Okay. Uh-oh. A loud knock on the door. Pierre goes to check the commotion. He finds John the farmer on the doorstep. His face pale as a sheet, completely out of breath. Oh no. Some shit is about to get fucked. Okay, his face don't look that pale. Okay, he needs help. What's wrong? Those bastards have raided our farm. The entire crossroads is swarming with them. Okay. Don't worry, I'll help you out. Get a sword. The old man's got a sword. He's got the right fucking idea. Nope. He's fine. He's fine with it. He's just going to go and punch armored and heavily armed men. And why not? Oh, the boxes respawn, but the money doesn't. That's alright, it's fine. Okay, they put the mine into the... Oh, yawning now. Oh. Very tired, I might have a little nap later. Might have a kip. Well, what do we have here? Or who do we have here? Remove your men from that farm this instant. Take me seriously. I am unarmored and unarmed. I'm Pierre. The swordsman don't take him seriously. He goes, rawr, enough! Okay. Well, that was pretty cool. I mean, he smashed the fuck out of that lot. Pick up one of their swords, Pierre. He don't give a shit. There are more soldiers up ahead. Get ready. They're over this way. I mean, there's no defense. I really don't get on well with games that do that. That have no defensive ability whatsoever. Let's get around. Let's try and line them up. There we go. Well, they got two of them anyway. Especially because each swing leaves you so wide open to attack. Have that and all. Okay, well, we're at the quest marker, but I'm guessing they just want us to take out all the soldiers that are around. Because there are some down here, so let's smash these guys up. There we go. Backup is coming. I don't know if I can take on more of these soldiers. We won't give up that easily. Prepare yourself. He's an old man! Leave him out of it! From the west, okay? Oh, here they go. That's a fucking shit ton. We have to hold this farm. Oh, Jesus Christ, don't fucking leave me open to attack with a dialogue bar going. You prick. They've taken his wife. Oh no, let's get her back before it's too late. Where did they come from? It was dark. I did not hear them until I was already too late. I think. Wait a minute, they took your wife ages ago and you've only thought to bring it up now. It's like, protect the farm first. And her second. What an... John the Farmer's an arsehole. I just realised he was called John. I feel bad that I didn't get to say John, you know, the farmer. Being a fun reference and all. But you don't get everything you want in life. You do not, no sir. Right. Let's go get your wife, who you only just remembered needs rescuing. Will you give us anything now? Right. Okay, so he doesn't sell us weapons at all. So this is... He goes completely with fists. Alright, that's fine. Door kick. Double fist. I don't know what that does. Oh, that. I guess that's an area of effect attack. So we go up and down on the D-pad to switch attacks. So what the heck are you two peasants doing here? Men, two arms! There we go. So that doesn't send... Oh, fucking hell. Fucking dialogue boxes appearing during the fight. It's bad enough that he won't target anything. It's like you're so incredibly beautiful and full of fish. Thanks for that. Right. It's the end of those bastards. I'll get you and all. Oh, no. I'll tell you where they've taken the farmer's wife. Speak, coward! But lie to me and I swear it will... Actually, he is starting to resemble more and more my D&D character, Cosard Craid. My latest one.
Speak, coward! That's how I do him. But lie to me and I swear it will be the end of you!
They have taken her to the farm just across the bridge. Okay, he'll signal the guards.
Ratting out on your own men! I'll let you go. Better stay away from those soldiers from now on. They will have your head for what you did. I'm Cossard Craig.
Anyway. So he's upset. What have I done? Right, signal. Let us through. Actually, is that what we're supposed to do? No. We've got to go the other way. Oh, okay. Do a little punchy-punchy. That's right. That bar will refill by the time there's more trouble. We need to be careful. If we get caught by those guards, they will kill my wife for sure. I'll take care of this. You stay here. What does he mean by that? Is this stealth? I think it's stealth. I guess stay out of the light. Oh yeah, you've been captured. I was hoping to try and like sneak through. He could have just punched this one. It's just one bloke. You could have just... I'm not even going to question him. Okay, so what's the best way of doing this then? I guess we're going to have to go around the back way. Well, we'll get this first. Why not? Okay, let's be careful. Look at this game, having a giggle with some stealth. Oh, fuck it, I don't know where he's gonna go. Yeah! We can't attack at all. Come on! Can get stuck on the scenery. Okay, there we go. Stay away from me. Shh, quiet. Actually, I imagine he would just be, shush, quiet, I'll get you out of here. Your husband is waiting for you. Okay. Let me get a little yay from her. He told us to be quiet. Okay, don't you shush me. I'm getting, just get me home safely this instant. My God, they're all fucking dumb. They are all dum-dums. Okay. Now the fight's beginning. That was pretty awesome. That wasn't awesome as he just punches the air next to him. This is ridiculous. No. Actually hit the dude. You fucking fanny. Yeah. Hilarious dialogue. At least the health regenerates fairly swiftly. Well, this isn't quite as good as I was hoping. I actually was expecting a good game. But it's fairly piddly. It's like half a Mad Max. That's how I'm rating things by mediocrity now. So I'm laughing at my own naughtiness. Okay, let's just get this wife to the farmer. I think Pierre's going to neglect to mention that she was an afterthought. Thank heavens you've saved her. The soldiers are coming in great numbers. Mill. Okay, they need to go to the mill. Quickly, if they burn down the mill, the entire land will be flooded. Oh, shit. Well, we wouldn't want that, would we? How do we get to the mill? Okay. So that road. I think pressing the map makes him do his attack as well. I swear I did not hit circle. To the mill! Off we trot. Okay. Right. Looks like they have completely blocked this road. I don't give a shit what they've done. Can we cut through here? Is this a way? Yeah, it's a way. So, yeah, it's gonna let us go all the way through, I think. Cool. I'll smash that up. Look at that. Didn't get stuck. Oh, there's some prick here. The Miller. I'm afraid you'll have to get through one of the roadblocks. The soldiers kicked us out. Okay, perhaps you'll have more luck with the roadblock just east of here. There are fewer guards. Worth a shot. Find a way to get to the mill. We can do that just fine. Okay. Miller was right, blah, blah, blah. Smash these fuckers up. I think. There we go. Knocked them sparkers. Get out of my way, farmer. Incidentally, just bought a new, some new audio equipment for the live action parts of the Gymquisition. Very excited about it. Should be, might, probably not here for the next episode, but the episode after. Finally getting a really nice posh lav mic that goes directly into one of those recorders. So it'll be a little, I've never done that before. I normally put things directly in the camera, which I know isn't great quality, but I'm really terrified of trying to sync audio. But I realized I do that enough with these videos, so it shouldn't be much different, you know. Obviously just do a bit of a clap or something before I start talking so I can sync it up, and it should be fine. So anyway, the Saxon soldiers did some stuff at the mill. So that'll be nice. That'll sound nicer. Because I got a new camera recently for the Gymquisition. I don't know if you've noticed. I feel like it's got some nicer clarity to it, a nicer colour to it. Anyway, this is going to do his toughest fight. I don't much care about this now. I'm talking about the Gymquisition, which is more entertaining. So I got a new camera, but the old mic I was using sounds awful on it. I have to run it through some filters and stuff just to get it to sound decent on the shows now. So I thought, better get a new mic, but I want to do it properly this time. And of course that's where, the Patreon stuff's going. I've been making all sorts of improvements to the tech where and when I can. Getting advice from a friend of mine, Maxwell Rorig, has been helping me do audio stuff. So that's going to be cool. Looking forward to that. And of course, I have to put audio treatment up and everything in the office, so reverb isn't as bad as it was. It's still not perfect. I mean, I've still not finished doing all of the audio stuff, all of the treatment. So there is still work yet to be done. But it's already improved, I feel. Just gotta run around a bit and wait for my health to come back up. Oh no, here's some other fucks. Help ourselves to some gold while we wait. Get that health regenerating. And then we'll head back into the fray. Should be full by the time we get there. And of course all the audio stuff's in addition to all of the fun props and things I've been getting as I've been making the intros and outros of the Gymquisition more entertaining. Which a few people don't like, but largely most people seem to be loving that, the intros and outros now on the show, so I'm pleased with it. Most people are digging it. Okay, what's happening now? Oh no, more guys. Oh my god, just a lock-on system or something would have been nice. Oh, he was spinning all over the place. I mean, I pressed all the buttons and saw nothing locking on. If there is one, I've not seen it. You've saved hundreds of people. He wants to go home, though. Close fire objective. I'm going to look in the options. I'm going to see. We'll look at key binding just to see. Especially like interact, toggle. Select special next. No, nothing about locking. There is attack in place, which I guess would kind of maybe help. I don't know what button that is on the controller. Doesn't appear to have one. Not one that I've, I mean, I've just been pressing buttons. Yeah, I don't think that, I don't think we have a key for it. Anyway, you know what? We've had a big fight. That's fine. I'm happy with that. I'm going to go. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed the video. We'll be back, you know, we've got videos going up all the time on this channel. So enjoy this. Go watch Nitpick Theatre if you haven't seen it already. I'm really pleased with that series. I've done my third episode today. And I'm hoping for it to become a regular thing. And for it to be, you know, I always hope everything I do is going to be successful. But I really think there's potential for this one. So if you've not seen Nitpick Theatre yet, go watch that. That series is up there. I'll be putting it on the main channel page as a playlist when I have 5 so that it looks nice in the columns and everything. But anyway, that's a thing. Go listen to Podquisition if you want a podcast. That's up on the jimquisition.com right now as well, so that's something. Yeah, I think I'll just go.